About a year ago, I compared Intel's integrated HD 4600 graphics against a GeForce 710, you know, two GPUs that we all love to hate, but I found that they actually performed about the same. Now, some said that the 710 with GDDR5 RAM would do much better, and well, I tested that too, and it obviously did. So let's try this again and put this new 710 up against the 4600 and see what happens. So for this video, I'll be using the GDDR5 version of the GT710, which has all the same specs as the DDR3 model, just with faster memory. For the CPU, it's an i7-4770 using the same board and CPU as last time, but since it's been, you know, some time since the last video, I'll be rerunning all of the tests again. So first up, let's take a look at video encoding. For this, I'm using Handbrake and encoding the video with QSV on the integrated graphics and NVENC on the 710. And it looks like the integrated graphics blew away the 710. It encoded 34 frames per second faster and finished over a minute sooner. I ran the Heaven benchmark with low settings at 720p, as both have limited VRAM. And Intel won again, averaging 2.5 FPS faster. However, with that said, the 710 was much smoother. You can see the stuttering and jerkiness of the integrated graphics. So although the integrated graphics averaged a higher frame rate, I think the 710 did a better job here. But that's your call. Now, in superposition, also running at 720 low, the 710 pulled ahead nearly 4 FPS on average. Yeah, that's better, but I still gotta give credit to Intel here. That's still pretty good for integrated graphics of its time. In Fallout New Vegas, since this was an older game that barely predated either of these, I had everything set to Ultra at 1080, and yeah, the 710 scored over double the average frame rate. However, with that said, if needed, it was still very playable in the integrated graphics. I'm sure if I just dropped the resolution down or even knocked it down to the high setting, we'd be close to 30 FPS. On Unreal Tournament 3, I had it set to the 1080p low settings, and well, both did fine. The 710 averaged about 30 FPS higher, but the HD graphics at 61 FPS? Yeah, well, that's, I don't know, that's absolutely fine. That's even good. Need for Speed Most Wanted came out about a year before either of these, and both showed decent average frame rates and felt fine to play. There was a bit of input lag on both of these, and later I benched it on a 1030, and that lag was gone, so they both realistically performed about the same. Now, nothing against RAF, I actually found it really relaxing to play at one time, but I included in these tests because it doesn't use the most efficient game engine. And you can see here that the results are pretty similar. It was definitely better on the 710, far less lag, although neither were good, and I don't think I can really play this on either.
Encrypto, do verify your suit is working under Earth's atmospheric conditions. Get a move on!
Destroy All Humans, when released for PC, was never meant to be run on either of these. Even at 720, the frame rates were bad, although it felt much better to play on the 710. On the integrated graphics, there was nearly a full second of input lag. GTA 4, now this one was a little odd. The frame rates look okay. Not great, but not terrible when you're considering what we're using. But even though the HD graphics averaged 10 FPS lower, it felt better to play than the 710. The 710 had crazy amounts of input lag, and as you can see, the frame times were all over the place. Where with the integrated graphics, it was just solid. So yeah, if I had to, I'd much rather play this on the integrated graphics over the 710. GTA 5, again, this was interesting too. The integrated graphics averaged 3 FPS higher, but the 710 felt far better to play. The integrated graphics had a lot of input lag, and you can see that this is the total opposite of GTA 4, where now the integrated graphics have frame times all over the place. And of course, I didn't forget Portal 2, and no, that's not a mistake. The graphics and all game settings were set the same for both, yet the integrated graphics averaged 146 frames per second, which is over double that of the 710. And it felt fine to play on both, very little, if no lag at all. So So you can see with Heaven, the HD graphics using QSV encoded the fastest, with both versions of the 710 performing about the same. And if anyone's wondering, just a simple software compression with all graphics acceleration disabled leads to it encoding a little over 50 FPS on average. And here's a look at the two GPU benchmarks compared. In Heaven, the GDDR5 version of the 710 definitely did better, but the HD graphics had a higher average frame rate. However, if you remember, the 710 was definitely smoother overall. In Superposition, the 710 pulled ahead slightly. However, you could see how far behind these fall when comparing it against, you know, another not-so-powerful GPU. The 1030 is often thought of as another meh card. Not great, it's just there to give you a video output. It doesn't even have NVENC encoding support, but even that card scored far higher than any of these. And here's how the games compared. I have to admit how impressed I am with the integrated HD graphics, and how disappointed I am in the 710. I don't know, maybe I'm old school, my mind is stuck in the thinking that if I have to install a GPU to my computer, no matter how crappy it is, it should outperform the integrated graphics. And that's just not always true anymore. Also, with this 1030, if they would have just released a version of that with NVENC encoding, there would be no need for the 710. They were priced about the same and had similar footprint, yet the 1030 just blew the 710 away. Now some will say, but they weren't released at the same time. Yeah, there were different generations, but they're not far off from each other, and both were still sold at the same time. We don't live in a vacuum. Things do overlap. Well, that's all I got this time. Hope everyone's doing well, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.